this is an example of a really key principle in parallel programming, and indeed in all of computer science. We call that principle Amdahl's law. The total speedup you get is limited by the portion of the time you spend doing something that can be parallelized. In the limit of enough parallelism, you know, doing a good enough job with parallelism, having a parallel enough machine, your maximum speedup goes to 1 over 1 over p, where p is defined as the percentage or portion of parallelizable times, time spent on this parallelizable activity. So it's really important that you know these limits. So for example, if your application spends 50% of its time on I.O., just reading and writing to the disk, then that implies that you can't possibly do better than a 2x speedup. Unless, that is, you can come up with a way to refactor the computation. For example, maybe you can read and write larger batches of data at once, so that the GPU has more work to do on a single batch. And I want to say this situation comes up pretty often in practice, right? GPUs are so fast that often porting the hotspot to CUDA makes that hotspot so much faster that it's no longer the bottleneck. And that's why I made the point earlier that if you have a bunch of functions, you might need to do more than port a single hotspot to the GPU, right? You might find that after you've ported that first hotspot to the GPU, it's gotten so much faster that now you need to focus somewhere else. And remember, once you've crossed this point, there's little point in continuing to optimize this. The total time on your application is not going to go down very much if you continue to work on this hotspot. You need to shift your attention to the new bottlenecks.